on the pass the word on.
Professor Bucaglione, I would like to make some personal remarks and then I sit down. In 1939, I was a boy, 9 years old. And I must confess, I was enthusiastic on Hitler. And I was enthusiastic on all the victories which Nazis met through Europe, especially Poland. And after the war, I was very ashamed. I had to learn and to change my political opinion. I had to learn, especially the authoritarian fascism. I had to see and to learn the world with other eyes. 50 years ago, I could not imagine that I would be here and to live with another opinion, and therefore I'm very thankful for your invitation, and I can do something for cooperation today in the world of freedom and humanity.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
As a beginning, I would like to ask a question. Do we still have authoritarian structures in our German society? Even 57 years after the end of the Hitler regime? Or is this question inadequate? I have a preliminary answer. The authoritarian thinking and behavior today is much more finer and often not recognized immediately. Therefore, it is even more important to recognize them and to become more conscious of them. For the advancement to a human society, it is a requirement that we analyze the thinking and behavior of our society. It is necessary to gain a consciousness of our social and individual values and motives. Often we still can discover old structures, even today. I would like to attribute those structures, even today, to an archaic behavior or to a patriarchal society, or to a fascistoid behavior. The word fascistoid is not found in English. I don't know how to use it. Erich Fromm defines the task of becoming conscious as a task to solve the giant problem of a collective repression. I would like to point out characteristics within two fields. The first field is remains of a general authoritarian thinking and behavior. And the second field is the structures of power and violence. I come to this first field, remains of authoritarian thinking and behavior. And there I have 4 chapters. First is the call for a powerful leadership. Non-responsibility in authoritarian leadership, we have to see. Many people, even in our society, like to subjugate themselves to a strong political leadership. This permits them to have no own responsibility. This immaturity, what's that in English, Unmündigkeit,
immaturity. Perhaps we have a Polish impression, it's important, immaturity. This immaturity can be shown in two figures. Opinion polls resulted in surprising figures. One figure, 50% of German citizens are not interested at all in politics. 50%. The second figure, about a quarter of all citizens does not take part in a political election. Erich Fromm calls this a very difficult problem of collective repression. I would like to describe the consequences of this non-responsibility by some examples. Political leadership with authoritarian traits and features. A leadership by a patriarchal politicians seems to be very sympathetic because many citizens have no own view on political things. They subject themselves uncritically to a powerful appearing government. They believe this government will carry out good politics and makes good political decisions. An example of our recent German history. Until 1989, the overwhelming majority of the German people had the opinion that Germany never again should have a military engagement out of area. Out of area means out of Germany. Two federal chancellors with authoritarian traits were able to convince the most people that a military engagement of German forces all over the world is necessary. The state as an institution for total welfare. Many citizens want to have a state that provides a round-up social welfare. The government should be responsible for the entire social security of everybody. Behind this mentality, there exists a profound lack of own responsibility. My impression in our present so-called crisis of the social welfare state is that we live more in a crisis of the responsibility in the majority of the society. Instead of practicing first an own responsibility, the citizen flee into the welfare service, which should be organized by the state. Erich Fromm calls this an escape into authority. The state is considered responsible for the entire security of the society. In home policy, media intensify several fears, for instance, the fear of the loss of jobs. Or the fear of too many foreigners. These fears force the government to carry out a more rigid policy. With regard to foreign policy, I discover artificial scenarios. Many politicians maintain growing dangers by terrorists or by Islamic aggression. In consequence, the government is urged to more rigid and unprogressive policy. Erich Fromm has summarized all